Hey everybody, hey YouTubers, hey subscribers, as always, thank you guys for watching and taking your time and sharing it with me, and same to you first time viewers. Okay, this is it. This is the video that everybody needs. This is pretty much the end. This is the last SOS. Everybody who, you know, who is a sheeple needs to, you know, wake up, because this is it. This is the last warning. And I'm about to show you undeniable proof and give you anything and everything you need to hopefully wake up your family or friends. Okay, let's talk about what happened yesterday. It was called Black Friday. May mess, unemployment goes up, stocks collapse. This summer, eerie echo of pre-Lehman Market 2008 collapse. World Bank, leaders ready for impending catastrophe. And in fact, if you scroll down here, it says that it was Hell Day yesterday, but they really call it Black Friday. Okay, now let's talk about what also happened during the week that caused all this stuff to happen yesterday. There's all these factors that determine what they do with the economy. That's housing, it's shit, it went down for the seventh month. There's a stock market, which you've already seen collapse. Unemployment goes up. Consumer confidence is another factor. It plunged. It's all stuff that came out this week. Manufacturing, huge determination. Missing and plunging again. So, all these things, they all are big factors in what they do with the economy. It all is how they decide what they're going to do. Now, how I know that this is going to end awful, and how it's going to end with martial law and money printing and talk of 50% tax rate or cutting the programs, you know, welfare, food stamps, Social Security, all that stuff. You know how I know that? Because this also came out this week as well. This is pretty much the most important one of all. This is all you need. U.S. debt soars by $54 billion overnight, closes May at record $15.77 trillion. All this stuff is going on. This is the only answer they have, and there is no other solution being brought to the table. Not in Europe, not in America, not in China, not anywhere. This is the only answer they have, is to solve these things by debt. This is the only solution they have. And you know how I know it's going to end the way it's going to end? Because you see this story that came out? I think this was even last week. Spain's biggest bank is asking for their biggest ever bailout. And guess what? That's because of this. This story was how this story came about. Except for this all started with a country called Greece. And it went from Greece to Spain to Ireland to Italy. The entire Eurozone, that's how it started, with this story. It started with this story, and then it said, Greece needs biggest bank out or bailout ever. Now it says, Spain needs biggest bailout ever. And this is their answer. More debt. Because they have not even touched government spending. They knew how this was working out, and look what happened this week on top of all the awful economic news. And we got the World Bank ready for an impending collapse, catastrophe. And even just to put the icing on the cake, JP Morgan, they're cutting our third quarter GDP forecast from 3% to 2%. So you got pretty much the worst economic data you could pretty much ask for this week. JP Morgan comes out, like one of the top five, if not the biggest bank in our country, comes out and says that they're going to revise their quarter three forecast from 3% to 2%. So we have all this awful economic data now in the second quarter. They're saying, well, we're going to go ahead and cut down the third quarter forecast to 2% because we obviously see that it's slowing. And not only that, we're shaving our 2012 GDP outlook from 2.3 to 2.1%, and they're going to leave their quarter four forecast unchanged at 2%. So nothing is getting better. The economic data for this quarter shows that. They're admitting it. Hey, nothing's going to get better. It's going to either, at best, stay the same, but it's not. It's going to get worse as all this, these next, their plans come in place, which is either print money or take. I listen to two guys. One guy, he trades for a living, and the other guy, he writes books for a living. And these are the two guys that I pretty much mainly listen to, and their choices are quantitative easing. austerity, you know, cutting plans, raising income taxes, just like they did in Greece. That's what Greece and Spain and all those guys over there are riding over, is over that stuff. That's the other thing. That's their options. Austerity, money printing, cutting reform, or cutting plans, you know, Social Security, welfare, food stamps, cutting those. Or take, as the other guy said, a 50% cut across the board, which I guess means everybody squashes their debt by 50%. And the only way to do that is to devalue your currency by a huge number, by 40%, like they did in the Great Depression. Because if you have $100 million worth in debt, you know, but you devalue that currency to 40%, well, now you only got about what? $60 million debt. Right? It's easier to pay it back. No, didn't work after the Great Depression. It's not going to work now. Those are their two plans. That's it. So, I want to read this to you as well. We're screwed. I mean, we're screwed. I'm sorry to say that, but you guys, we got 3 months. Because that's when this final debt ceiling comes about in September. And I don't know if they're going to print money up to that point, or they're just going to wait until September and say, hey, we cannot raise this debt ceiling anymore. So either A, devalue the currency by 40%, you print money, hoping that that'll work, and we print the most money we've ever printed in our whole lives, or goodbye Social Security, goodbye welfare. Every one of them things ends in massive death, massive suffering, massive rioting, massive social unrest. This came out this week as well. There's this global macro investor, and he's this big, huge, super smart guy, Raoul Paul, and he used to work for Goldman Sachs, and he has his own big, huge, one of the largest GLG partners, one of the largest hedge funds, fund groups in the world. Let's see what he says. So this guy's no dummy. He knows what he's talking about when it comes to this stuff. He talks about all this debt. All that equates to 1,200% of global GDP, and it rests on very weak foundations. So there's 1,200% more debt than there is income throughout the entire globe. This is the end of the fractional reserve banking system and of fiat money, the dollar, anything on paper. It is the big reset. We have around 6 months left of trading in Western markets to protect ourselves or make enough money to offset future losses. After that, we put on our 10 helmets and hide until the new system emerges. What's in the middle there is this more reiteration. So, I got... Hi. So, everybody who's been telling us that we're wrong, everybody who's been telling us that we're crazy, they're about to look three things: very scared, very foolish, and very hungry. So, just like this is your mission, whether you want to accept it or not, you need to get as much stuff as you can in the next 3 months, because whenever all this stuff goes down, this is how the history books are going to write it. A man set himself on fire in Tunisia because he couldn't keep up with his debt. He couldn't keep up with his money, causing an Arab Spring, which revolutionized the entire Middle East. The debt crisis jumped over to Europe, causing the same sort of revolution leading to the European summer. That same debt crisis jumped over to America, and the entire region, North America, South America, jumped the other side of the globe, caused a similar thing, leading to the fall of America. And then the entire globe went to the same thing, sprinkled with the little Fukushima catastrophe that drove the entire globe into the nuclear winter. This is exactly how this is going to look. We have 3 months to stock up on whatever you can. Buy silver, buy gold. I'm going to do all my money. It's coming out of the banks, and it's going into a credit union of some sort, because for whatever reason, I guess the regulations are different. They're local, I guess. So I'm doing that because that's a better chance. And then it's going to start taking more and more money out. And I don't know if I'm going to bury it. I don't know if I'm going to hide it in this house. But I should have had another story up. I think it was also on Zero Hedge. The police are telling people, don't take your money out of the bank. So do not believe that when they tell you that. Because they're just the same police are going to be the same police keeping you from getting your money out of the bank when you can't get it from the bank when they say that you can't have it. Do not believe them when anybody on TV says, do not take your money out of the banks. Do not believe that. Do not believe that at all. So here is your mission. Stock up on everything you can right now. You have about 3 months to do it. And in the meantime, be as safe as you can possibly can and show everybody you can possibly can, because your mission now, because nobody's going to... I'm sorry you got mocked. I'm sorry you got scoffed at. I'm sorry you were ostracized. I'm sorry you were ignored. I'm sorry. I am. I apologize like hell. And I know you never wanted to just say I told you so, because what's about to happen is about to be the only thing that's going to... The only thing you can call is an apocalypse. What's about to happen. Everything in the movies was true. There's no reason, you know, there... It's your job. It's our job. It's your mission. I'm not saying it's your job. I didn't mean that. I'm accepting this. This is my mission. I wholeheartedly accept it, because I'm going to try and do my best to save as many people as I can, survive through it, and then it's time to save the world after that. Because if I make it through this, what happened here is never going to happen again. It's never going to happen again. And if I lose my life in the process because of something that's caused from this, like an earthquake kills me, or I go up to a state official and I get shot speaking my mind, I don't care. This will never happen again. This is the dumbest thing. History repeats itself. It's time for those of us who want to help and make this better for our children, and so we can just, and if you don't want children, just to make it better so you can have a happy life, a utopia that everybody wants. In the movies every time, anytime in these kind of situations, Keanu Reeves in The Matrix, Bruce Willis in The Fifth Element, you never want the mission. You never want it. You never want it. Like, I don't want to do this. I can't do this. I don't know how to do this. I don't want it. I know how you feel. And I'm telling you right now why I accept this mission. Because I know that I am not alone spiritually. And I know that I'm not alone physically, because of people like you that watch this stuff and feel the exact same way that I do. There is hope. I'm not alone. Neither are you. We can do this together, and it's up to us now, because this is it. So thank you guys for watching. This is your mission, and I hope you accept it, and I'll see you guys on the lighter side either way, because we got this. That's what the devil wants to do. If he wants to wipe out all the sheeple and put it preppers and conspiracy theorists and spiritual people against just us against them, they're not going to like how it ends. They're not going to like how it ends, because I know how it ends, and it does not end in their favor. So thank you guys so much for watching. You're not alone. We can do this. Let's go to work, teammates. Love you guys.